should be interesting.
This could be a smoke show.
That kid has a lot of talent and a lot of potential. We're gonna do this. We're gonna give her a shot in the UFC.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. The UFC returns this weekend with a fresh face who is destined to make headlines. When UFC President Dana White went looking for a fight, he was hoping that he would end up with a future UFC star. And those are the expectations after he signed a regional champion who has dominated the local women's strawweight circuit en route to her octagon debut this weekend. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
Coming up next, it's a UFC women's strawweight division matchup.
Damn, I forgot to take myself on mute.
And man, did she come through in a high-pressure spot that night. Tonight, though, decidedly more pressure. UFC.
I've been on mute for probably about 3 hours, bro.
And everything that accompanies the UFC experience. You know about the famed UFC jitters. Not a factor for every newcomer. She doesn't look wide-eyed right now. But if there is an adrenaline dump, how does she deal with that and remain in the fight?
This girl has outstanding submissions. She is definitely going to want to try to take this fight to the ground and lock up a submission. She is very good from both the top position and working from her guard, and her takedowns are good as well.
Well, when you watch film on her, hard to see anything in terms of weaknesses, Joe. She is a true mixed martial artist. Plus skills in all areas. Really not going to jump off the page in any one discipline, but
Echo.
She has proven to be a handful for just about anybody and just about everywhere the fight goes. With her skill set, she is comfortable anywhere inside that octagon.
This girl's a very well-rounded fighter. Now, some fighters, they have a specialty, and if they're taken out of that specialty, they lose a lot of their effectiveness.
Not I don't know why all of a sudden I just like, yo, let me check to see if the audio is on her.
She is standing up.
Yeah, stay on your side of the ring.
Our tale of the day.
I don't know what you're smiling for. Fight.
More than 5 years apart, with similar height and some differences in reach.
Oh my God, girl. Got the T-Rex arms. Stampede country. The who? What they call her? The cougar?
All right, here we go. All right, so here she is as we get ready to go for
I'll wait for her to counter. What a result,
what a knockout. And here it is again. Boom! Out cold.
She got some big ass thighs.
That's a knockout they'll be talking about for quite some time. What a moment for this fighter here tonight. The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mugliotta has called a stop to this contest at 12 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Black Mamba.
All right, so a nice job to get the win in her UFC debut here tonight as she begins to celebrate with her coaches. A lot of pressure, of course. We talk so much about those famed UFC jitters. Not a factor for this young woman here tonight.
The partner's ass.
And I'll see you at the fights.
Hey, gotta go where the money at.
It's a UFC women's strawweight division matchup.
Her face on the regular screen looks nothing like her face when she actually like fighting and doing everything else.
Well, for my money, Joe Rogan, this woman right here is the most accomplished submission specialist to come to the octagon in years, and I think for a lot of the opponents she'll draw, they're just not on this level. Even if they're drilling submission defense for an eight-week training camp, you can't simulate her in training. And she doesn't discriminate, too. A lot of different chokes in her arsenal. Excited to see her skills tonight if this fight hits the ground.
This girl has very high-level Brazilian jiu-jitsu. She is absolutely world-class on the ground. You're going to see fast transitions and beautiful, clean, sharp Brazilian jiu-jitsu technique from her.
Well, when you watch film on her, hard to see anything in terms of weaknesses, Joe. She is a true mixed martial artist, plus skills in all areas. Really not going to jump off the page in any one discipline, but she has proven to be a handful for just about anybody and just about everywhere the fight goes. With her skill set, she is comfortable anywhere inside that octagon.
This girl is a well-rounded mixed martial artist, and the advantage to that is she's comfortable no matter where the fight takes place. If her opponent wants to stand, she's comfortable there. If her opponent wants to try to take her down, she has excellent defense. If the fight goes to the ground, she has an excellent ground game. So she is fully well-rounded, and because of that, she's much more confident no matter where the fight takes place inside the octagon.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age, with similar height and reach. And now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this woman is a jiu-jitsu fighter.
Black Mamba. Now I feel like I need to go back and remake all my guys, because now I done figured out a better way to do them. So her name is Heather Haymaker Hensley, huh?
Start. She certainly made a lot of noise.
got me with the leg.
Beautiful KO for the victory.
She got me in the leg.
Yeah, Joe, how about the knockout there? Beautiful technique to land the fight-ending shot. And again, we're a broken record when it comes to this, but sometimes when you catch a fighter cold, maybe before she's had a chance to get herself into the fight, that strike can have a bigger effect.
It's made her head bounce off the cage.
Great angle here.
I was giving her a chance to react.
Boom!
Try to do a counter.
All she wrote.
Well, she got some big ass feet, bro.
Talking about for quite some time. What a moment for this fighter here tonight. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 29 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout.
Well, there are few greater highs in all of professional sports than to have your hand raised inside that octagon. But she took it a step further tonight. Massive knockout victory. No TKO here. This was a flush KO. She's probably getting some bonus money. One thing I can guarantee you, she is getting a massive, high-profile opportunity next. Congratulations as the celebration continues following the big KO tonight.
I thought she got me with the leg. I thought she got an event with the when she got me in the leg. Thigh. Whichever one. Talk about Tiffany Charles.
This girl's wrestling is at a very high level. She has very good trips, very good throws, excellent control, and very good ground and pound as well. She is a real grappling specialist.
So we want to keep the stand up with her. She kind of got a little booty.
Between these two fighters when it comes to the age with similar height
I got
and
that reach
differences in reach. Now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the corner, this woman is a jiu-jitsu fighter with a professional record of 5 wins, no losses. She stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of corner Prince Haiti. What? And now introducing your opponent, fighting out of the red corner, this woman is a grappler with a professional record of 6 wins, 4 losses. She stands 5'5" tall, weighing in 114 pounds, fighting out of Los Angeles, California.
I want to wrestle, but I want to get the wrestling practice down, but it's so many wrestlers. There's so many females that wrestle and do jiu-jitsu. I got to stand up with them.
Fighter
Look at her face. Like, her face looks totally different, bro.
Take a look at this from a different angle. Boom! Right on the money. And there she is after the huge knockout.
We'll switch it up after we when we get to like the top contenders. We're just going to breeze through all these pre-fights, the pre-challenging fights.
Well, she's got all the tools, Joe, and she's certainly
look, her face looks totally different. She's like she's 46 years old in that picture. I mean, right there. But in the picture, she's like she's about 25. Like Brenda Shaw.
You see there with her coaches and her teammates, nothing better in all of pro sports than to win a mixed martial arts fight at the highest level. Congratulations. And coming up next, it's a UFC strawweight division matchup.
Definitely don't look Vietnamese.
In striking range, and you got to think the focus for the opposition tonight.
It must have been something from the war.
Range of those fight-ending weapons at all costs. This girl is a very high-level striker. Unpredictable angles. She will throw punches and kicks with vicious intention. Excellent hand and foot speed. Very good striker and very good takedown defense as well. And she will need that to try to keep this fight on the feet. Well, she is a really accomplished submission specialist, and candidly, Joe, not a lot of women are used to facing opponents on this level. She's got to be thinking tonight, how quickly can I get this fight to the ground and set up my high-level submission game? A lot of different chokes in her arsenal. She attacks from a lot of different angles. Very strong lower body, particularly her hips. Very excited to see what she can do tonight if this fight hits the mat. This girl has outstanding Brazilian jiu-jitsu. I have seen her roll in the gym. I have seen her work out with a lot of very high-level fighters, and her submission skills are outstanding. Our tale of the day for this strawweight fight.
Oh, my God.
More than 5 years apart, with similar height, but the difference is in reach.
Chick.
Here's Bruce Buffalo.
7 inches? Yo. You got power. She didn't land that one? Okay, whatever. Whatever, bro. God damn it, fucking 90. What'd it feel like? I was like, what, 110? Let me hit refresh. Okay, now I say it's only feel like 92. Great skill set, but certainly it's the striking defense that comes out when you watch the film. She'll use movement and defense to set up her own offensive angles, but she'll hang out in the pocket because she's so confident in her ability to stick and move and get her head off of that center line.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. More than 5 years apart, and they both possess the same height and a similar reach. Here's Bruce Buffer. Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC strawweight division. She comes in fighting. This woman is a grappler with a professional record of 5 minutes.
I wonder how much United Center owner gets paid to have a or United gets paid to have they, the arena listed in all these different games. For real. For real, y'all. Beautiful KO for the victory. Bruh, I was trying to go for a submission. She lead right into it. Bruh, for real. Seconds.
Well, Joe, I gotta think the only thing better than winning a UFC fight is winning one against one of your chief rivals, and that is exactly what we had here tonight as she celebrates with her coaches and training partners. Big, big moment in the career of this fighter here tonight.
So I'm gonna tie the record for the fastest knockout. By Jorge Masvidal. I remember that one too. I ain't see that fight live. I've seen the highlights. But I almost forgot that that one had happened. Man, I need to get some wrestling fights in. Damn, I did not pay attention to that. It said win all fights by stoppage. Oops. I did not peep that. Oops. I have never looked at that line with this fighter. Oh, bruh. Man, these fans be fickle, bro. I don't even know what these fans want.